Now the recording is on. A recording of this is going to be placed on our blog later, so we can reference it in the future. So this presentation is about accelerated mobile pages and what it means to you. If you have any questions, either click the chat icon at the top of your screen. You can see it in the upper right-hand corner. It's a little chat icon. Simon and Vince Paul are monitoring the chats through the meeting as well as through Twitter. So if you have any questions, you can ask us directly through Twitter. Tweet us at the BBS Agency and hashtag AMP, and we will answer your questions as well. Some of the questions we'll answer immediately during the meeting, particularly if it's pertinent to what I'm currently talking about, or if it's something a little bit more in depth, we'll dive into it at the end of this webinar because we've left some time for questions and answers. So first, a quick introduction. I am Vincent Wandra. For those of you who I have not met or talked to in person, Vincent Paul, or Vince P, is helping monitor the chat, as is Simon R. I am the founder of the BBS Agency. We just celebrated our third year in existence, and we're going strong into year four. We are a WordPress and WooCommerce consultant and development agency. All we do is WordPress, all we do is WooCommerce, and we do it very well. We don't work on Drupal, we don't work on Joomla, we don't work on strict HTML, CSS, or custom CMSs, content management systems, unless we are migrating you over into WordPress. I am a top-rated freelancer on Upwork, which used to be called Odesk. Matter of fact, I was a top-rated freelancer in 2013, 2014, and 2015. And our agency, which is newer than I am, was a top-rated agency on Upwork last year. I have literally been developing websites for 20 years. Yes, I started in 1996 when the internet was just taking off. I kind of recognized that it was going to be a big thing back then. I immediately started taking classes, learned how to do some basic HTML and CMSs, and was kind of dissuaded from pursuing it further at that point because the technology was so new. I wasn't ready to dive into it. However, I always have had websites of my own since then. If anybody remembers GeoCities, I used to have a GeoCities website, as well as a bunch of other just small pet projects throughout the years. Throughout the course of my career, I've had the privilege of working with some amazing companies, such as IBM, Heartland Precious Metals, One-to-One Marketing, Ready-Made Resources, Mech Labs, Westwork, Forge Digital, BusyWeb, the Excelity Group, Cabot, Something or Other Publishing, Brent Dozar out of Chicago, Rapid Buy, In Touch Business. I know Julian's on this webinar. I've been very privileged to work with a lot of really, really good and amazing companies. Everybody does things their own way, and everybody brings something unique to the table. And we try to learn from the best of every company we've ever worked with and apply it to our own clients. So this is why everybody's here. What is AMP? AMP stands for Accelerated Mobile Pages. It is all about mobile content in the mobile web loading instantly, absolutely everywhere. Doesn't matter if you're home, if you're in your office, if you're in the big city, if you're in a small city, if you're out in the boonies, if you're in a first world country, if you're in a third world country, wherever you are, if you have mobile internet access, it's going to load just like that. Okay, now, as we go through this, remember, this is for the mobile web only. This is particularly for the web developers out there, because there's a lot of restrictions with what you can do with AMP. And immediately as a web developer, and this is how I approached it initially, trying to get my head around it, is, oh my God, I completely have to change how I redo websites. This is going to suck. Or all these things we've been doing for lead generation or things to improve conversions, man, how are we going to get those to apply? Everything you've been doing for desktops and laptops and primarily tablets that are going to be on a broadband connection, that is kind of going to remain unchanged, at least for the short term. All those bells and whistles, if you have a pop-up that shows up on a desktop, that's going to keep working. Your beautiful WooCommerce web shop, that's going to keep working. This is for the mobile web only. Anything with a really small viewport like this, smartwatches, things along those lines. Remember, Accelerated mobile pages are designed to load instantly on mobile devices only. This was an initiative announced by Google October 7th of last year. Heard about it, kind of started paying attention to it. I've learned, because I've been doing websites for a long time, if Google's pushing something, pay attention. You're going to need to know about it at some point. Most of their things are successes, like Gmail, for example. That's been a huge success. Google Apps, a huge success. Google Plus, not so much, but it still has influenced how we do things today. Okay, now, they've also announced it is open source. So that got me paying a lot of attention. A lot of things that companies do, particularly the big technology companies, they try to force everybody to do things their way. Microsoft, I'm looking at you. Okay, not everybody wants to do things the Microsoft way. Open source is where the source code is available to everybody. WordPress is a really good example of open source. People from all over the world can contribute to WordPress and make it work everywhere, and everybody has a say in how it's going to work. It's one of the reasons why WordPress powers 25% of the web today. So when Google announced this, they decided to go the open source route where anybody can be involved in this project. February of last month, Google started rolling it out. Now, it hasn't directly impacted you yet. Right now, that started the rollout. It's a very slow rollout. It's primarily developer-type tools, and we'll look at what's available so you can see how AMP is going to affect you in the future. Now, to be determined, this option right here in the presentation, the big push is coming. There's no time set on it yet. When Google pushes their AMP update to the Google app on your phones and the Chrome browser on your phones, that's when you're going to see AMP take off, and you're going to see it everywhere in the news, and those companies who are prepared for it are going to start to see dividends immediately when that happens. Okay? AMP pages will have /AMP appended to the URL. So if it's yourdomain.com/mygreatblogpost/AMP will be the URL for the page. It will also be accessible through the normal URL with your normal mobile responsive experience. Google is going to be pushing AMP aggressively in 2016. They have said this repeatedly. This year, they're pushing it, and they're pushing it hard. They also have the backing of a lot of really, really big companies. So, just taking a look at this, Google, Twitter, Pinterest, the New York Times, the Washington Post, the BBC, BuzzFeed, WordPress, Time Magazine. Now, one thing a lot of these companies have in common are they're either media or publishing companies, or they're technology companies. Okay, keep that in mind because it's going to be important as to in just a little bit. Okay. Now, there's good, there's bad, and there's ugly about this. First, let's look at the good. This is really, really good for published content like news stories, blog posts, video posts, image posts, social media, anything that is sharing new, current, relevant content. This is really, really good for it. That's why all the big publishers like the New York Times, the BBC, BuzzFeed, the Washington Post, they really are backing this because it's going to help their content be read everywhere. Okay. The other good part about it is those who've taken the time to have AMP integrated into their website, their AMP posts have the potential to show above normal Google search results in a new section called Top Stories. Now, this graphic just showed up. This is what Google searches are going to look like on your mobile device once the AMP update is pushed out to Chrome and pushed out to the Google app. Notice there's a new, so you put in your search term, there's a new section at the top with image carousels where it's going to pull in a bunch of news posts called Top Stories. Okay, stories. So if you're on WordPress, these are not your pages, these are not your products, these are your posts. Okay, you're going to pull in the title of your website, it's going to pull in your featured image, it's going to pull in your it's going to pull in the title of your post, and it's also going to include this lovely little AMP sign to let people know they click on that, it's going to load up just like that. And then notice, Also in these AMP search results, there are no Google ads anywhere yet. And Google has said when they do incorporate ads into these search results, they're going to show up underneath the top stories. They want to really encourage companies to embrace this AMP and giving you the potential of pretty easily having page one results on Google is a pretty good motivating factor for a lot of companies. Okay, another good news. If your website is powered by WordPress and more recently Drupal, this is going to be fairly easy for you to integrate. So congratulations if you're already on WordPress. If you're not on WordPress, if you're not on Drupal, talk to your web developer. Okay, now the other really, really good part about this is this improves the web experience for everyone, not just me on my smartphone, sitting in my office on Wi-Fi. This improves it for me if I'm in the middle of the Canadian wilderness on a fishing trip and I have somehow have mobile web, I'll still be able to get the recent news. So this is good for the person who is living in a third world country and that is their one connection to the world and how they know what's going on. They will have a great mobile experience. It's not going to be just for those with the latest smartphones and those who are on 4G networks. This improves the web experience for everybody who has a mobile web connection. Okay. Now, as far as search results go, this is straight from Google. This is where we got this picture from. Okay. This is how Google's going to rank sites. Your average mobile responsive site, it's going to be in the pack. It's going to maybe be on page one, depending how many people are searching for your terms. But those who are on AMP, they're going to be way up at the top. And the way to ensure you're going to be on the top is where you have a hand-tuned site. Now, this is primarily where the New York Times and the Washington Post and the BBC are, because they have a dedicated team of people working on this stuff. But if you have an AMP site and your competition doesn't, you're going to be up here and your competition is going to be way back in the pack. Now, there is some bad with AMP. Okay? Many websites, particularly proprietary CMSs, which stand for content management systems, they have a lot of work ahead. I've been paying attention to AMP in the news for a while, reading a ton of blog posts. Some publishers, particularly those who are already on WordPress, for example, the New York Times, they're pretty excited about this. This is some really good potential for them to do better than their competition. And then there are their competition who spent millions of dollars developing their own content management system, looking at this going, are you kidding me? We now have to spend hundreds of man hours and millions of dollars to convert our system to get everything switched over. So for some companies, there's a lot of work ahead if they want to embrace the accelerated mobile pages. Okay, subscriptions and paywalls. This also applies to e-commerce sites. Okay, every paywall is unique. Now, by paywall, I mean like you charge people to view your content on your website, or there's a subscription base to view the stuff on your website. Okay, there are challenges involved in making that stuff compatible with the AMP project. However, a core objective of the Accelerated Mobile Pages project is to support them, okay? Now, we have a little editing difficulty here. One of the other things that makes it unique is there's no third-party JavaScript on your sites, okay? This means a lot of those great tools that you can, services you can sign up for, and they say, hey, take this piece of code, drop it onto your website, and something's going to happen, be it a pop-up, certain types of analytics, certain types of website tracking, like click maps and heat maps and stuff, those all happen from JavaScript that calls in code from another site. Those do not work on AMP pages. They'll work on your normal desktop pages, just not on the ones that have been optimized for AMP. So, Google Analytics implementation, as you're currently doing it, not going to work. Requires Google's recommendation is a separate Google Analytics property specifically to track your AMP pages. And there are some tools we'll look at later for integrating that into your code. So you can see how well your website's performing normally and on normal mobile devices and how well your website is working on those AMP pages. Okay, as I said, it's got to be integrated separately. This also affects many other third-party systems like AddThis. We like AddThis. AddThis, for those who are not familiar, it's a third-party service for social sharing buttons on your website. So that's your like, your tweet, your plus one, your share via email type buttons you see on a website. AddThis, it's third-party JavaScript. We add it onto the website, but their service does more where it provides analytics behind the social sharing. So if someone, say, get 10 shares on Facebook, I can see that those 10 shares on Facebook resulted in another 500 people seeing my post. Those analytics really help you see how viral your content's being. It doesn't work with AMP pages. Great tools like reseller ratings. For those who are not familiar with reseller ratings, it's primarily for e-commerce websites. You put this code on your website, and if you purchase a product, the third-party review system. So there's a little bit more trust involved. So you get an email from a third party, independent party, says, hey, did you like the product that you purchased? Could you please rate it? And it puts your review and the stars of the review on your website and also in Google search results. If the page that someone's viewing is an AMP page, that's not going to work. Tracking pixels. If you're doing any sort of advertising, you usually want to see the results of your advertising. Those tracking pixels don't work on AMP pages and many, many current advertising platforms. Okay, and that's one of the reasons behind this AMP project. Google and a lot of the partners involved on this looked at what is hurting the mobile web experience. And a lot of it is you go to some of these news sites, and I'm going to name one that I kind of like. It's called 411mania.com. It's a great geek news website. It's comic book news and movie news and WWE wrestling news like that. I like the site, but there are ads all over this site. And when I try to view it on my smartphone, it is a royally painful experience because it takes the pages forever to load. And that's me on a 4G connection. If I was, you know, on a 3G connection or worse, it would be completely unusable. And it's all because of the vast amount of ads. So in order for these advertising platforms to work on AMP pages, they have to work with Google and the AMP project to make their code compatible. Right now, there is only a handful of ad services that work with AMP, Google AdSense being one of them, naturally, because Google's the pushing force behind this. Now, there's been good, there's bad, we're going to get to the ugly. AMP pages are like any other page on your website, but with limited technical functionality. Think of the web back in the year 2000 for functionality that we're talking about. This is CNN pulled from the Wayback Machine. This is what CNN looked like in the year 2000. Now, your websites hopefully are not going to look this bad, okay? But what I want to highlight is the functionality that is here. This page is pretty much, it's hyperlinks, it's text, and it's images. And that's about it. And that's pretty much what you're restricted to on an AMP page. There are ways to get around that that are approved by the AMP project, which we'll talk a little bit more of in a second. Okay, but really stripped down on, you know, year 2000, JavaScript really wasn't a thing. So there was no pop-up showing up. There was no lead gen form that appeared. There were no ads integrated into the middle of the page. Okay, so what's limited or what doesn't work? Forms. Most forms aren't going to work. So that beautiful lead gen form you have, sorry, right now it doesn't work with some exceptions. Sliders. And sliders are thankfully on their way out of popularity because studies have shown they don't convert really well because people don't sit really through the first slide. They maybe go through the first slide, maybe two. They never see what's on the third or fourth slide. Those don't work. E-commerce. Now, if you run an e-commerce website, don't worry, okay? People will still be able to find your site and your products through normal Google searches, and they will still view the normal, hopefully mobile responsive view of your website and your store. However, if you convert your product pages over to AMP pages, they won't be able to check out, because those checkout buttons and the add to cart and stuff won't work. Google's working on that. Like I mentioned before, it really has to do with the whole paywall functionality and being able to process payments in an AMP type format. So it's coming, it's not there yet. Remember, the focus of AMP right now are for like news stories. So your blog posts on your e-commerce store, those could be AMP ready, while your product pages would be normal. Okay. Now, the way we can get around these limitations is via some AMP code called AMP-iframe, specific HTML format designed for AMP. And yes, I said iframes. For those who are not familiar with an iframe is something that we really don't use anymore on websites. They've kind of phased out over the last bunch of years, thankfully. An iframe is a section of your web page that is essentially a window to another web page. Okay, so the way you get around these limitations, for example, with your form, is you can insert your form through an iframe. Okay, it's a little bit complicated. There is really no tools to make that easy yet. They're coming. Remember, AMP is very, very new. Okay, now, before you panic, let's look at why. And remember, this is mobile only. It's very small screens. When I first heard about AMP, I kind of was like, I'm not too happy with it. I honestly wasn't a big fan of it. But once we started diving into it, the more I learn about it, the more I see the potential for what it can be. The fact that it's got a lot of big companies behind it and they're pushing it really, really makes a lot of sense. And this is going to drive web development moving forward, particularly mobile web development. But all in all, it's going to be a good thing because the end user experience is going to be better. So remember, the whole AMP project is about bringing a fast mobile web to everyone. Okay. This is a map of the average connection speed around the world. Now, I couldn't find one specifically for mobile, but this map kind of applies. This is broadband in general. Okay. All the places in red, which are primarily what we view as the third world countries, they don't have the infrastructure to have 4G speed to everyone. More so, nor can the people who live there afford 4G. I have a family of four. We have 4G. We're on data sharing plan for my entire family. It's really, really expensive. So they just don't have the money, they don't have the infrastructure, they don't have the capabilities. Okay. Here in the US and Canada, yes, we have the money and we kind of have the infrastructure, but we're really big countries. Everything is spaced all over the place. That's why, you know, if you live 20 miles out of town, the only really solution you have for broadband internet is satellite internet, which kind of sucks. And you probably are lucky to have 4G mobile speed. Chances are you're still on 3G. You know, smaller countries like some European countries, or like if you're in South Korea, where there's a lot of people in a really small area, really fast internet isn't an issue because everybody's close. And these are countries where everybody's a little more successful. They can afford it. So if we bring a mobile web that is fast to everyone, this means billions of potential new readers for your content, billions of new viewers for your advertisements, potentially billions of new followers on social media, potentially billions of new buyers for your product. And this is the kind of the really nice view when you're looking at the globe as a whole, billions of new informed and educated people who really couldn't use the internet and the mobile web to their advantage. They can now stay on top of news and current events. If you're living, say, in the Middle East and there's an attack that breaks out, so it's a terrorist attack, or God forbid, there's another war that breaks out, everybody's social media lights up. Here in the US, over there it does as well. Well, here in the US, our infrastructure can handle that sudden burst of data. It can handle the sudden burst of thousands of images and millions of images and millions of messages being sent. Over there, it can't. It overwhelms their systems. And God forbid, if someone takes out, say, some mobile towers or some key infrastructure, all that bandwidth that is being sent for these messages will overwhelm the local network. However, if those news stories that people want to know about what's going on are AMP friendly, they're all cached on Google servers, which I think I forgot to mention before. All the AMP pages, they're cached on Google servers. So they're served up incredibly fast. The data amount required to send those AMP pages is really, really small. those people in those areas will be able to get the news and stay abreast as to what the heck is going on. In addition to that, it puts online self-education and organized, so such as services like Lynda or even using services like YouTube.com, within reach of a lot of people, as well as organized education, like many of the online colleges and universities. You know, I've taken a lot of online classes, and by and large, with the exception of the interfaces, the stuff they're giving to you, it's pictures and it's text. That is stuff that's a great candidate to be cached on Google servers and served up instantaneously. So when you look at the global picture, and not just us who live, you know, maybe in the United States or someplace in Europe or someplace in Australia or someplace where we're a first world country, when you're looking at the rest of the world, this AMP really, really is going to help them and potentially open up a lot of new markets for us as entrepreneurs. So when is AMP coming? Google started rolling it out last month. Okay, right now, you're not seeing it in your search results yet. The big push, I mentioned this before, and I'm saying it again because this is important. When this happens, and Google hasn't said when it's coming yet, but it's coming this year for sure, when Google App and Chrome for Android and iOS get their updates, this is when it's going to start to make a really, really big impact. Okay, so talked a little bit about what AMP is, why it's going to be around. Talked about that it's got limited functionality and kind of going back to how we did things in the year 2000. So what does an AMP page look like? Take a deep breath. It's not as bad as you think. Okay, so first, this is the blog post. You probably signed up for this on. Okay, this is our website, the blog post announcing this. Okay, some of the functionality we have. So it pulls in our company's name. We have the ubiquitous hamburger menu that you see on just about every mobile responsive site. It's got our title. It's still pulling in our image. We use Add This for social sharing. So you can see our Add This bar at the bottom. When I took the screenshot, been shared 12 times. Okay. An AMP page looks like this. Still pulls in the title. We actually have the tool we're using for this AMP. It makes it easier than the tool we're using to create our mobile responsive menu. It makes it easier for us to pull in our logo. We played around with some of the built-in styling. Now, it's limited styling, but we were able to easily pull in our color. We were able to pull in some meta information, and we have our title. What's missing? We're missing the social sharing bar. That's it. And this page loads up on mobile about 2.3 seconds. This page over here, AMP integrated, loaded up instantaneously. Okay, so everybody watching, I'm going to take a guess that you probably have a smartphone. I want you to pull out your smartphone, and I want you to open up your browser and go to g.co/AMP demo. I'm going to do it right here with you guys as well. So I use the Chrome browser. I don't believe it matters which one you're using. We're going to go g.co/AMP demo. This is the first part of the rollout from Google, so you can test things. Now I'm going to hold my phone up. It loads. It looks like a pretty standard Google search. Now, so we're all looking at the same thing. I want everybody to type in the word Mars, M-A-R-S, and search. Okay. And you're going to see a notice at the top that says this is an accelerated mobile pages demo, and underneath that are top stories. So, typed in Mars. Here's what it looked like when I took the screenshot a few days ago. There's been some updates since then. For whatever reason, I'm seeing, the first story now is SB Nation. DeMars, Ronda Rousey's great-grandfather, and it continues on now. He was actually a physicist. And you can scroll over and you can look at all these other AMP stories. Every single one listed here. Note the top story section. Note the AMP symbol next to each one that's got AMP. Now, click on that first entry. Doesn't matter which or any of the other ones that are flagged AMP. So I'm going to click on the Ronda Rousey one. That page loaded up instantaneously on my smartphone. There was no delay. There was no nothing. This is because it is cached on Google servers. Okay. Now, depending on which of those top stories you saw first in your search experience, you or which one you clicked on, you may have seen some delayed elements. So when I clicked days ago, when I took this screenshot, and this particular post I clicked on was from the Telegraph. This video here loaded up a little bit slower than the rest of the page. That whole page came up like that. That video, which had some interactive elements, came in a little slower. That's because it was done via the AMP iframe. So for developers, the page itself was cached on Google. It came up instantaneously. That AMP iframe part was actually pulled off the source server, which is why there was that slight delay. Okay, so remember those iframes, they're back. There's going to be some creative uses of them, I'm sure, to get around some of the AMP limitations in the upcoming months and years. And you have a little bit of an advantage. If you've been coding as long as I have been, or you remember coding and doing iframes, a lot of the stuff that you knew before worked. If you've never used iframes before, Google how to use them. There's some great free online resources. Okay, now, this is the first thing that I wanted to know when I heard about AMP. How can we benefit from it? Okay, I'm an entrepreneur. I run a company. You guys who are watching, you probably run companies or you're developers and you have clients of your own. You want to know how can you use AMP to either help your clients, or if you're running your own website, how can you use AMP to help your business? Now, website owners, this is a really good opportunity for getting page one exposure in Google via top stories. If you blog at least once a week, if you blog even more than that, this is really, really important for you, because this is a great opportunity. If you, once Google does that push to the Google Chrome and the Google app, your pages, if they're AMP ready and your competition isn't, you're going to get that top story slot. Google has said so as much. Google almost never tells people when they're going to get page one ranking on Google. They've said that about the top stories. The only way to get there is if you have AMP. And if you're the only person regarding that search term that someone is looking for and you have AMP, you will get page one ranking. Okay? Google has also said they will favor AMP posts in search results. Now, this is different than stuff Google has done before. Okay? I'm going to actually go back just a second. We're going to focus on number two. Google before has told people what their website will get penalized for. They've always been kind of general with what they said your website will rank highly for. So they've said if you provide really good, relevant content, you have good page authority, you link to good, high authority resources, and they link back to you, a lot of social shares, your website will and page will naturally rise in search engine rankings. That's pretty generic. Google has said on mobile searches, if you have an AMP page, your posts will get favored. Okay, Google last year released an update called MobileGen. Okay, and it was something they'd warned people about for about 2 years. If you did not have a website that looked good on a mobile device, you were going to drop in rankings on mobile searches. Okay, so right now, if your website looks terrible on a smart device, you've been seeing searches for people when they're on their smartphone looking for you in Google, you've been slowly dropping in page rankings. Okay, this is the exact difference. If you do AMP, it's mobile responsive, you're actually going to go up. Very, very important and very exciting. It's a good opportunity. Number three, beat your competition to AMP. If you have AMP ready and integrated blog posts, and your competition doesn't, you are way ahead of the curve. Okay, and if you're on WordPress, making those AMP integrations is going to be fairly quick and painless. Okay. Now, if you want to know about that, contact your developer or contact us and we can help. And we'll help scope it out and let you know what it's going to take. We've already have two clients who we switched over. It's just a few hours of work and they're already set and ready to go. Okay, developers, Google said so. This is coming. Be prepared. One thing I learned a long time ago, when Google is the big dog on the block, when they say they are going to do something, pay attention and listen. They are going to put their might and their magic behind it. And even if it's a failure, it's still going to affect how things are. I don't think this is going to be a failure. I think it's going to be an overwhelming success, partially because it's not just Google. It is Google. It is WordPress. It's the New York Times. It's Twitter. It's Pinterest and all these other big companies putting their might behind it. Okay. This is going to be a big thing. It's going to really drive how things are done. Pay attention. Get ready for this. Okay. This is Mobilegeddon 2.0. Okay. The first one was make sure everybody's got a website that looks good on mobile. Now it's, yeah, your website looks great on mobile. Let's make it work really fast so everybody, everywhere can view it and enjoy it. Okay. This will also drive website development in the foreseeable future. Okay. Right now, there are talking about WordPress infrastructure. There are only a handful of plugins available for AMP. And there are no themes that are designed with AMP integration in mind yet. There's none that I've seen. Okay. This is going to affect how websites are developed in the future. 60% of online searches are all performed on a smart device. We have to be prepared. This is where everything is moving. Just like with the website owners, offer this AMP integration before your competition does. Just like mobile responsive website design, it used to be where only a few guys were doing it, and now everybody's doing it. Same thing's going to be with AMP integration. We're ahead of the curve because we're offering this to our clients already. And if you're a developer and you're watching this, get ahead of the curve. Follow the AMP project. Offer this to your clients before your competition does. Okay? And also, change equals opportunity. Yeah, I initially wasn't too happy about the AMP initiative. I'm like, ugh, I got to figure out and find some new tools and figure out how we're going to do our websites differently. But the fact is, there's some really golden opportunities here. Be the first to offer AMP templates in your commercial themes. Nobody's doing that yet. Or AMP-friendly plugins. We're working on some internally here. Okay. Nobody's doing this. This is a brand new golden opportunity that you guys are ahead of the curve because you're watching this video and you're educating yourself on it. Think about how you can incorporate AMP into offerings for your clients and then push that and offer it to the rest of the world and build your business based on that. Okay, now, the rest of this discussion is going to be pretty much WordPress focused because that's what we do. Okay, there are some really great tools available for WordPress. The best of the best. First, it's the AMP plugin by Automattic. If you are a WordPress developer, you know Automattic is the company behind WordPress and WordPress.com, a network of 60 million plus blogs. They're the tech guys behind the New York Times, okay? These guys have partnered with Google from the get-go. This plugin, it's available for free at the WordPress plugin repository. It's a must-have. Now, what it does is it provides theme-independent AMP HTML templates. AMP HTML is a subset of the standard HTML language. And these are theme independent. So if you're using the Genesis framework like we do, this is not anything that directly affects your theme. When someone's viewing your site in AMP mode, it actually overrides your theme settings. Okay. And now also notice the version. This is version 0.3.2. This stuff is very, very new and cutting edge. Okay. Expect this to change quite a bit until the official 1.0 releases. This is very much a beta release. Another company that is very involved, and I've been following their blog religiously because, number one, I like what they do with SEO. Number two, they're really staying on top of this AMP, are the guys from Yoast. They've released a plugin called Glue for Yoast SEO and AMP. Eventually, this stuff is all going to be integrated into the Yoast SEO plugin, but not yet, because this, just look at the normal version number, same version number as the AMP plugin. They're rapidly changing it. It's still in beta form. Once it's in a stable form, once AMP has had a really big push, you're going to see it all get integrated into the main Yoast plugin. Now, what does it do? It adds basic AMP HTML styling to your posts. If you just put the AMP plugin on from WordPress, your pages are going to show up and they're going to be really, really generic. It's going to be strictly black and white. It's going to be strictly your text name of your site across the top. And it's going to be kind of boring, kind of eh. So what the Glue for Yoast does is provide some ability for you to go in and choose at least what hex value colors are as far as your title goes, your font goes, as far as the header bar that your logo is going to appear. It provides the ability for you to add your logo into the header now. And it also makes it easy to add Google Analytics into your AMP pages, which is really nice. The other advantage of the glue for Yoast SEO is it keeps your Yoast meta on AMP pages. Now, Yoast SEO is a tool we build into every website that we do. It's a very, very powerful search engine optimization tool that helps the search engines understand what your page is about, how important and how authoritative it is. Okay? If your page does not have glue for Yoast SEO on it, all that work you've done with the on-page SEO doesn't show up in the default AMP template. Okay, the glue for Yoast makes sure all that meta description, that meta title that you've created are going to still show up. However, it forces a circular logo. For whatever reason, I'm hoping they're going to change that. We upload our logo, it puts a 50% curve on your logo, so even if it's square, it now appears circular. You can overwrite that with some custom CSS. I expect Yoast in a future release is going to have some other options. There is a good alternative for Yoast. It's called Facebook Instant Articles and Google AMP Pages by PageFrog. It's a mouthful. Here we just call it the PageFrog plugin. For those who don't know, Facebook Instant Articles are an initiative by Facebook to pretty much accomplish the exact same thing as AMP, except it's Facebook and Facebook pretty much alone forcing this on people. If I put my money down and go, well, is Facebook going to win this battle, or is Google and all the companies behind them going to win this battle? I'm going to go with the Google side because they're going to win this battle. Okay. Now, it's got similar styling and Google Analytics options as the glue for Yoast. It can also do the Facebook Instant Articles if you're interested in that. Your logo is 32 pixels high, same height restriction as glue for Yoast, but you can make it wider. So you can kind of make a horizontal logo if you want. It does not, however, include your Yoast meta on AMP pages. If you're not using Yoast, this is going to be a really good solution. If you are using Yoast, you probably want to lean this way. There are two other plugins. These are fairly new AMP plugins. One is called Project AMP. We tested it out. It's got some of the styling options as the other ones, but it's very, very raw and unrefined. And then there's this custom AMP one, similar to Project AMP, similar to the PageFrog one. It is very, very new. We have not had an opportunity to test it. Oof. So, where can you learn more? There's some really good resources out there, but I'm going to point you at the main one, the ampproject.org. This is the main AMP website. Sorry, I'm getting over a cold. Watch the introductory video. The introductory video has a lot of the bigwigs from Google and Twitter and BuzzFeed and a lot of these other really big companies discussing why the AMP project is here and why they decide to do it now. It's a really informative, really good video to watch. The fact section answers your questions and it kind of explains the method behind the madness. You know, what is AMP? What can I do? What can I do? But it keeps it at a pretty high level for even the non-developers so they can kind of get a grasp as to what's going on. The doc section, that's where your guides and reference material are. If you're a developer, this is where you're going to want to spend most of your time. This is where they talk about the AMP HTML subset, what you can do, what you can't do, how the AMP iframes work, and things like that. The blog, it's hosted at, there's a link to it off the ampproject.org, but it is hosted at amphtml.wordpress.com to stay on top of what's going on. You know, I mentioned that WordPress got behind Google almost immediately on this. As you can see, they've been hosting their blog there as well. Okay, GitHub, this is an open source project. If you're a developer and you would like to contribute to AMP and contribute to how the mobile web is going to be done in the future, head on out to GitHub, get involved in the conversation, start coding, submit your code to the project, and help shape the world. And maybe someday you can go back to your kids and go, hey, back in the 2016, 2017, 2018, I helped do all this code that's driving the web today. Okay. talk to your web developer. Hopefully they know about AMP and they've been doing some research onto it, or contact us, and you can contact me directly at vincent@thebbsagency.com. I'll be willing to answer any of your questions and help assess your current website situation, see what we can do to get your blog post on AMP. So when that big push happens from Google to Chrome and the Google app, you're ready and you can hopefully get some serious search engine traffic on your website. Okay. Do you have any questions, guys?
Yes.
All right. If anybody has any questions, feel free to click the chat button at the top of the screen. Ask me any questions. If not, you can contact us at thebbsagency.com, facebook.com/thebbsagency, Twitter @thebbsagency, or you can email me. A blog post of this will be added onto our blog later this week, and you guys you can reference it and share it around the web and inform anybody else about it whatsoever. Thanks, everybody, for attending. If you have any questions, get hold of us. Thanks a bunch, and have a good evening.